So if we look at Tyson Fury, he's got another rematch against Wilder coming up. He is a Frank Warren guy. So yeah. What do you think, were you shocked about the last result, and what do you think is going to happen in this rematch?
I was shocked with the result. I thought like Fury, I think that most people that Tyson, the only rounds that Tyson lost was the twice he got knocked down, which was miraculous how he managed to sort of get up off the floor in the second knockdown like The Undertaker. But it was, I think Tyson Fury is the best heavyweight in the world. I just think his size, I think he's like, consider the size of him, I think he's a phenomenal athlete. I think because, you know, look how fast he is. He's like 6'8" or 6'9". He's a big guy and he's quick. And even he's overweight against
wait, in which one?
Wilder, that's the one.
Oh yeah.
Sorry,
oh,
Wilder.
In this one, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So when he beat Wilder last time, he's like, well, obviously Wilder got the punching power, Fury's got the boxing skills. I think Fury's gonna, you know, he's probably gonna be sharper than he was last time, mm-hmm. but I just can't see Fury, like, he's not the biggest punch. I can't see Fury knocking at Wilder.
So I
think he'd be on points, and I can't see him stopping Wilder. But if Wilder's got that equaliser, do you know what I mean? He's got such a big punch. Like, if he catches Tyson on the chin, so he's going to have to be sharp for 12 rounds and be switched on, because I think he's dangerous, Wilder. When he's sort of hurt or he's losing, he's frozen wild looping punches from all different angles. But if they land, it's like normally good night. So I'll be interested to see the rematch.
But you do think?
Fancy Tyson to win that fight. He's a boxer, man, so I've got to go for the slick boxer. So I think Tyson will beat him this time, I think, on points.
And Billy Joe Saunders, there's rumours he's potentially going to fight Golovkin. That's if the rumours are true. Now he's obviously, he's moved to match rooms. Do you think that fight will happen? And if it does, who do you think has got that one?
Yeah, I think Billy Joe Saunders, you know, I'm really impressed with Billy Joe. He's an excellent boxer, has good skills. I know he stepped as super middleweight. I don't think he's going to carry that much power as a super middleweight. I think his natural weight is middleweight, so I would like to see him come back at the middleweight, and I would like to see him against Triple G. I think he has the skills to beat Golovkin. Can he take Golovkin's power? We'll have to wait and see with that one. But yeah, I think Billy Joe, and time is everything in boxing. So Golovkin is, like 37, 38, and I think Billy Joe will raise his game again. If he fights Triple G, I think he could beat him. I think Billy Joe could beat him on points.
And what do you think of his move from Frank Warren to Eddie Hearn? What do you make of that?
Business is business, man. That's what happens, isn't it? It's boxing. Boxing is politics and business. So, fighters just want what's the best for them. You know, we just want, you know, it's a small window and we got opportunity in boxing. So, if you don't think you're having the right sort of whatever it is, fights, big fights, you want to go with a promoter you think is going to give you the big fights, and that's the way boxing is at the moment. That's it.
And so just looking back from you specifically, so in your prime, obviously everyone talks about the Froch fight, so you don't need to answer that again, but if you, in your prime and in Andre Ward's prime, who do you think would have got that?
You seriously asking me who would have got that? Do you mean to say, how would you have won that fight, Joe? Go and break it down.
You think you would have won?
Of course I would have kicked his ass. What are you talking about? So Andre was a great fighter. You know what I mean? He's a brilliant fighter. When you look at fights, you break down fights, you think, like, I would have beat that guy. But I think it'd be quite tactical. I think I'd outwork him. I think it'd be quite close fight because he's very, very cagey. Also, he likes to counterpunch. I'm also a counterpuncher. I don't like to attack fighters. I'd rather faint than let fighters come onto me, like Jeff Lacy style fights. And Andre Ward's very clever and he's very good defensively. I'm very good defensively. I think it'd be quite cagey.
But you,
I'd win the fight. I think probably my work rate would have, it could be a bit messy sometimes in some rounds. It could even be a bit like the fight with Hopkins a bit in sometimes, because he's a bit of a dirty fighter, and I could be if I get dirty things happen to me, I could be dirty as well. So yeah, it's one of them fights. I don't think it'll be on points, but whether it'll be a great fight to watch, I'm not quite sure.
Well, thank you very much for talking to us.
Thank you. That's it.